today we will discuss some states which occurs in the thyroid gland. Those states are the hyperthyroid state and hypothyroid state, which occurs in the thyroid gland. We will discuss those conditions. So the hyperthyroid, first one is the hyperthyroidism. As its name indicates, hyperactive function of the thyroid gland is called hyperthyroidism. When the thyroid gland become hyperactive in the late condition is called hyperthyroid state. Now, what are the causes of the hyperthyroid state or hyperthyroidism? So there are so many causes of the hyperthyroid state. Like the primary causes, in the primary state, those conditions which involves primarily the thyroid gland. The pathology exists in the thyroid gland, while in the secondary causes, there is pathology at the some other places or in the intermediate and the some other places and some other organs or tissue, and indirectly it involves the thyroid gland. And the thyroid gland become hyperactive, those states are called secondary causes. So in the primary causes, which involve the thyroid gland, are the Graves' disease, which is also called diffuse toxic hyperplasia, toxic multinodular goiter, toxic adenoma, iodine-induced hyperthyroidism. So these are the primary causes in the thyroid gland, which leads to the condition which is called hyperthyroidism. And in the secondary causes, there are thyroiditis and other causes which becomes the state of destruction of the thyroid gland. And there are some tumors or adenoma or malignancy in the pituitary gland, which releases basically the thyroestrogenic hormone. So when there is some pathology in the pituitary gland, this will ultimately leads to the hyperthyroid state of the thyroid gland. Or there is some abnormality or tumor in the hypothalamus, from where the release of the thyrotrophin releasing hormone. And if there is some disorder in the hypothalamus, it will also causes the hyperactive state of the thyroid gland. So those conditions is called secondary causes of the hyperthyroid state. So in the hyperthyroidism, how the patient will present and what will be their clinical features and sign and symptoms. So the symptoms by which the patient will present are the hyperactivity, irritability, dysphoria, heat intolerance and sweating, palpitation, fatigue and weakness, weight loss with increase of appetite, diarrhea, polyuria, oliguminuria, loss of libido. So these are the symptoms by which the hyperthyroid patient can present. There are so many symptoms by which the hyperthyroid patient can present. So any type of these symptoms the patient comes to you, that in your differential diagnosis, it will comes that it may be hyperthyroid state. And in the signs by which you can see in the patient are the tachycardia, tremors, swelling of the thyroid gland, which is called goiter, warm, moist skin, proximal muscle weakness, lid retraction or lid leg gynecomastia. So these are the signs by which you can see in the patient of the hyperthyroidism cases. Now, how you will diagnose the patient of the hyperthyroid state? So you will prescribe the thyroid function test. In the thyroid function test, in the diagnosis, you will see the clinical feature and thyroid function test, which will be your the lab findings. So those tests are the serum TSH, free T4, T3, thyroid, thyrotropin releasing hormone stimulation test, radioactive iodine uptake, and histopathology. So these are the five tests which you will perform, and then you will ultimately reach to the final diagnosis. So in the hyperthyroid, the thyroid stimulating hormone level will be decreased, but the production of the primary thyroid hormones, free T4 and T3, will be increased. So due to the increased primary hormones, T4 and T3, due to its negative feedback mechanism, the TSH level will be decreased. So free T4, T3 will be increased and TSH will be decreased. The third one is the thyrotropin releasing stimulation test, which you will do for the hypothalamus disorder, that whether it is a secondary cause involved in the cases of the hyperthyroid state. And the fourth one is the radioactive iodine uptake. In the cases of the hyperthyroid state, the iodine uptake will be increased by the thyroid gland. And the fifth one is the histopathology. And when you remove the thyroid gland, swelling of the thyroid nodule, and you will see it grossly and under microscopic examination, you will see the features of the hyperthyroid state under microscopic examination. The follicles will be hyperplastic and the colloid material will be increased. So these are the histopathological features of the hyperthyroid state. So by these tests, you can diagnose the case of the hyperthyroid condition. Now in the hyperthyroid, the most common condition is the Graves' disease. So we will discuss the Graves' disease, that what is Graves' disease. Graves' disease is the most common state of the hyperthyroidism. The patient of the Graves' disease presents with the hyperthyroidism features, ophthalmopathy with exophthalmos and dermopathy, which is also called pre-tibial myxedema. And this is autoimmune disorder in which most commonly the hepatocyte, human leukocyte antigen B8 is involved and DR3 is involved. So this is basically an autoimmune disorder in which the hyperthyroid state occur, and the most common features are the hyperthyroid state features and ophthalmopathy and exophthalmos. And in the case of the Graves' disease, you can also hear the sound of the carotid artery, which is called auditable bruit by the stethoscope. So these are the features of the Graves' disease by which you can see in the patient of the Graves' disease. So these are the signs by which you can see in the patients. You can see the exophthalmos features and lead leg and other features you can see in the patient of the Graves' disease. So this is the mnemonic for the remembering, to remember the features of the signs of the Graves' disease. So this is the nose pieces. Nose pieces, by nose pieces, in some cases, there will be no sign and symptoms in the early states of the Graves' disease. And O stands for the only lead leg or lead retraction signs. Soft tissue edema, which is also called periorbital edema, proptosis, extraocular muscle involvement, which is called diplopia, corneal involvement, which leads to the formation of the keratitis state, inflammation of the cornea, which is called keratitis, and sight loss because of the compression of the optic nerve. So these are the features by which the patient of the Graves' disease can present. This is the pathogenesis, a mechanism of the Graves' disease in which the by which you can describe that how the hyperthyroid state or the thyroid gland is enlarged because of the autoimmune disorder. So Graves' disease is autoimmune disorder, and autoimmune disorder is the state in which your own thyroid tissue says that there these cells are, the cells are not of your own tissue. The cells are not of your own tissue. The own cells, the own immunological cells attack the own tissue. This is called autoimmune state. And because of those autoimmune cells, because of those immunological cells, the tolerance to the cells like helper T cells and cytotoxic T cells will be lost. And this will destroy the causes the breakdown of the thyroid tissue. And how far it causes the breakdown of the thyroid tissue? By the formation of the ATTU antibodies. And what are those antibodies? Those antibodies are the thyroid stimulating antibody and growth stimulating antibody. So these antibodies are formed in the cases of the immunological reaction. And these antibodies then attach to the TSH receptors on the follicular cells of the thyroid. So when these antibodies attach to the TSH receptors on the follicular cells, it will ultimately lead to the stimulation of the follicular cells, by which increased number of the primary thyroid hormone like T4 and T3 will be produced, which is the state of the hyperthyroidism. And secondly, the number of the thyroid follicular cells will be increased, which is called hyperplastic state. So because of the attachment of these antibodies to the thyroid, to the follicular cells, thyroid follicular cells will increase the thyroid hormone level, and also there will be increase of the number of the cells, by which there will be a hyperthyroid state and thyroid gland will be enlarged. So this was all about the mechanism of the Graves' disease, that how the Graves' disease causes the thyroid gland enlargement. Here you can see that how you can diagnose the case of the Graves' disease. Graves' disease is the Graves' disease, the case of the hyperthyroid state. In the hyperthyroid state, the TSH level will be decreased and the primary hormone like T4 and T3 will be increased. And there will be thyroid autoantibodies by which you have described in the its pathogenesis, like thyroid stimulating antibodies and growth stimulating antibodies. So these antibodies will be seen in the serum. And the third one is the nuclear thyroid scintigraphy. This is the radioactive iodine state. Here you can see that this is the normal thyroid lobes. This is the one lobe, this is the other lobe. And in the normal condition, lesser amount of the thyroid will be taken. But in case of the Graves' disease, both lobes have taken the increased amount of the iodine. So this is the hyperactive state of the Graves' disease. And if there is toxic multinodular goiter, there are multiple nodule formation in thyroid gland, and they have the hyperactive state, and each nodule will take increased number of the iodine. And if there is single nodule, which is hyperactive state, which is called toxic adenoma, the single nodule will take increased number of the iodine. So these are the differentiating features that by which you can say that what type of the nodules have taken the increased number of the iodine. Now comes to the histopathological features of the Graves' disease, like morphology. In morphology, you will first see the grass appearance of the thyroid gland condition in the Graves' disease. And the Graves' disease, the thyroid gland have like the appearance like the liver parenchyma, like meat appearance, and the cut surface will be gray, dark brown. So these are the grass features of the thyroid gland in case of the Graves' disease. And there will be the symmetrical enlargement of the both lobes of the thyroid gland. By the histopathology, the thyroid follicles will be hyperplastic, they will be enlarged, and there will be increased number of the colloid in the within the follicles. And there will be the papillary projections, papillary enfoldings of the thyroid follicles. Here you can see the microscopic slide of the condition of the Graves' disease. This is the slide, microscopic view, in which you can see these are the normal follicles. This one is the normal follicles, and this one is the hyperplastic follicle. You can see the increased enlargement, huge enlargement of the thyroid follicle. And this follicle is occupied by the colloid material. You can see this is the hyperplastic enlarged follicle, this is the enlarged follicle, this is the enlarged follicle. So these are the features of the identification points of the Graves' disease in case of the thyroid gland. And here you can see that the thyroid gland, the colloid material is eaten by the own follicular cells. So this is called scalupe. Like you can take the ice cream by the spoon, so the spaces are formed. So those spaces are called scaluping. The thyroid colloid material is eaten by the inflammatory cells within the thyroid gland. So these, by like eating by the spoon. So the areas are formed, so those areas are scalupae. So the identification points of the Graves' disease in case of the thyroid gland are the hyperplastic enlarged thyroid follicles. These follicles are the filled by the colloid material, and the colloid material gives the form of the scalupae. So these are the features of the thyroid gland, and other features are the papillary enfoldings. So these are the papillary foldings. Papillary foldings are the finger-like projections. You can see this one is the basement membrane, and here you can see this one is the papilla, like finger projection. And this the papilla in the central area of the papilla is filled with the fibrocollagenous tissue, and the buds are taken out from the fibrovascular septa. So this is the finger. These are the finger-like projections. Papilla has the finger-like projection, and sometimes the papilla are the in the circular form. So these are the papillary enfoldings and other features which we have described in the last slide, like the enlargement of the thyroid follicles, scalupae, and filled of the colloid material. So these are all the microscopic features of the Graves' disease. Now the second condition is the hypothyroid state. In the hypothyroid state, the thyroid gland is hypoactive. The thyroid gland functions is suppressed. So this third condition is called hypothyroid. And what are the causes of the hypothyroid state? So many causes of the hypothyroid state, like autoimmune hypothyroidism, Hashimoto thyroiditis, atrophic thyroiditis, atherogenic treatment, thyroidectomy, removal of the thyroid gland, external radiations, developmental dysgenesis, thyroid hormone resistance syndrome, drugs. The patient or the subject taken some drugs by which the thyroid hormone synthesis will be decreased. Iodine deficiency, infiltrative disorders like amyloidosis, sarcoidosis, hemochromatosis, and scleroderma. So these are all the features, etiology, causes of the hypothyroidism, which leads to the hypothyroid state formation. Now, what will be the symptoms of the hypothyroid state? In the hypothyroid state, the patient will present with the tiredness, weakness, dry skin, feeling cold, hair loss, difficulty in concentration, poor memory, constipation, weight gain with poor appetite, horse voice, menorrhagia, oliguminuria, anuminuria, paresthesias, impaired hearing. So these are all the symptoms by which the patient can present in the case of the hypothyroidism. What will be their hyperthyroid state? You will see in the patients, his skin will be dry, cool extremities, puffy face, hands and feet, delayed tendon reflexes, carpal tunnel syndrome, bradycardia, diffuse alopecia, hair loss, serous cavity effusion. So these are the signs by which you can see in the patient of the hypothyroidism. We have the few states in the hypothyroidism, like the cretinism. This is the hypothyroid state, which occurs in the infancy or in early childhood. The patient will present with the skeletal disorder, bony disorders, inadequate mineralization, and CNS disorder. He will present with the psychosis. So the cretinism is the hypothyroid state of the early childhood or infancy, while the myxedema is the hypothyroid state in the adults or older children. So these are the two states in the hypothyroidism. Now, how you will diagnose the case of hypothyroidism? Like the hypothyroidism, you will advise the you will see the clinical feature, and you will advise the thyroid function test. And the thyroid function tests are the TSH and primary thyroid hormone T4 and T3. In the case of the hypothyroidism, the TSH level will be increased, while the free T4 and T3 level will be decreased. These are the primary hormones which will be decreased through the positive feedback mechanism. By the decreased number of the primary thyroid hormone, it will give the positive feedback to the pituitary gland to release the increased number of the TSH. So you will see in your serum that TSH level will be increased, will be elevated. So by this, you can diagnose the patient of the hypothyroid state. Thank you.